allow her to live 77 years. So we're here to celebrate her life, and we're here to lift up the name of Jesus, because this is the day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. Even in times like this, when we lose our loved ones, we don't lose them. She just found her way home. And no, we didn't lose Catherine. Nope, she came home to Mount Morris to see that old house, but the Lord had another house waiting for her, a house not made with hands, a house that she can see and not be able to feel any more pains, a house and a street paved with gold. Come on, somebody. Let's thank the Lord. Let's celebrate the life of Sister Catherine. Hallelujah. And we're in the hour of the family hour, I believe. Okay. So at this time, if you would like to take the time to greet the family or just say some words of encouragement, you can at this time, and we'll come back in just a little bit to start the program. Thank you.
It's okay.
I got to get some out?
Okay.
Yeah, I got to get mine.
I'm going to say, because you got to use it, so just leave it there. Okay,
so did
right.
you leave it EPN? I have one right
okay,
here.
Okay, thank
you. I need it back because I think that's Macedonia's EPN. This is Macedonia.
Macedonia. What is that? 82nd anniversary. You want it back? Okay, you want to pray for me now? Remind me. Let every heart say amen. Come on, let's say amen again. Certainly the Lord is good and worthy of all of our praise. In spite of the situation, I come by today to tell you that God is still good. Amen. Come on, help me out. Take your seats, please. Come on, help me out. Take your seats, please. Amen. In spite of the occasion, the Lord is still sitting on the throne. Amen. 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 All right. At this time, we're going to begin the homegoing celebration. This is, let me help us before we ever get started. We're not here for a funeral. We're here for the homegoing celebration of our mother, sister, grandmother, auntie, a friend, most of all, a child of the master. And we come today to celebrate her life, and I want to tell this family that earth has no sorrow, that heaven cannot and will not heal. Certainly, I want to acknowledge this family in such a unique and special way. I'm here on assignment. Mother Rising, I haven't seen you, but I know you're here somewhere. I got the call, and I'm here because you told me to be here. But I'm here because this family means a lot to me. I remember this family growing up, sharing with someone. I know I got some support in the house. I saw Andre somewhere. I said, you know, this was probably the only Beecher family that I really liked. Being a wildcat for life, this was probably the only Beecher family that I really did like. I like this family. Listen, we're not going to prolong this family long. Let me tell you now, we're on some time restrictions, and we want to try to do all that we can to do Miss Catherine the service that she deserves. But we have some time restraints, so I'm going to warn you now, if you're on to speak, I'm asking you to do what they've asked you to do and no more than they've asked you to do. Follow the program in the way that the program have been written. You come in to give remarks, I want you to start talking to yourself now and getting it down to the 2 minute mark. I promise you, you don't have but a minute and 46 seconds because this family is under some time restraints and we want to make sure that we get them where they need to be. Amen. But we're going to have a celebration today. We're not here for any other reason but to celebrate her life and the legacy that she's left behind. Amen. I'm certainly thankful and grateful to have Elder Joanne Brown here with us today and Minister Tawana Perkins here with us today. Minister Tawana Perkins is going to come and give us the Old Testament scripture, and Elder Joanne Brown is going to come and give us the New Testament scripture as well as our prayer. Gwen Pennyman will follow her, and then we will have the obituary and the acknowledgments from Linda Clay. Sister Danny Dye will come and give us a poem, and I will come thereafter.
Amen, family. To my Jones and Rising family, just want to say I love you. and I'm constantly praying for each and every one of you. And I will be reading from Psalms 23. The Lord is my shepherd. I have all that I need. He lead me to rest in green meadows. He lead me beside peaceful streams. He renew my strength. He guide me along the right path, bringing honor to his name. Even when I walk through the darkness of valley, I will not be afraid. For you are close beside me, the rod and your staff. Protect and control me. You prepare the feast of me in the presence of all. You honor me by anointing my head with oil. My cup overflowed with blessing. Surely your goodness and unfailing love will pursue me all the days of my life. And I will live in the house of the Lord forever. May the Lord have the blessings to the readers and doers of his word. Amen.
Amen. Again, praise the Lord, everybody. I will be reading from the New Testament, a very familiar passage, coming from St. John, the 14th chapter. And the word reads as follows. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. That in my Father's house are many mansions. And if it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. And whether I go, ye know, and the way ye know. Thomas said unto him, Lord, we know not whether thou goest, and how can we know the way? And Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. God's word is already blessed. Let us pray. Eternal Father, we come again in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We come, Jesus, as our author and finisher of our faith. Father, we come lifting you up, magnifying your holy name, even in times like this, Lord, when our loved ones have made their transition and made it on home. Father, we still gonna lift you up. We still gonna magnify your holy name. Now, Father, I come asking that you look down on this family, the Jones family, Father, and the Risen family. Oh, Lord, I ask that you look down on Charles, look down on Shine, look down on Cadero, look down on Sonia, look down on Sherry, and look down on Chico. Look down on all of the grandbabies and great-grandbabies, Father. And then, Lord, we ask that you look down on the siblings, Father. Look down and have mercy on them right now. Touch, comfort as only you can. Give them peace that passes all understanding. Oh, Father, lift their hearts up. Be with them in this time, Lord. We know that weeping endure for a night, but joy, unspeakable joy, will come in the morning. Might not be tomorrow morning, but the morning is coming. So, Father, we ask that you continue to watch over this family and keep them in the name of Jesus. Oh, Lord, and when it gets to the point they don't know which way to turn, let them look to the hills from which cometh their help. All their help comes from the Lord who made heavens and the earth. We thank you, Father. We lift you up and we magnify your holy name. Oh, Father, as we celebrate the homegoing of Sister Catherine, known as Cat, oh, Father, we just ask that we thank you. We just thank you. We thank you for her life. We thank you, Father. Oh, hallelujah. I said earlier, she came back home just to be in her home just a little while longer. But Lord, you had a home for a maid, not with hands, Father. And we thank you that you have accepted her and welcomed her to her new home. So we thank you. We lift you up. We magnify your holy name. And we'll be ever mindful to give you the honor, to give you the glory and to give you the praises and all these blessings we ask in your son Jesus' name. And let all God's people say amen, 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 hallelujah, amen. I'd like to say hello to the family, and my prayers are with you. I love you guys. Don't cry for me, because I've gone to a better place. Try not to cry for me, because I've seen my Savior's face. Remember my smile and the things we used to do, how you were always there for me, and how much I love you. So celebrate my life, celebrate the years, celebrate our family, and wipe each other's tears. Celebrate the laughter, celebrate the fun. One day God will wipe away your tears, and sorrow will be gone. Ooh, don't cry for me, because I'm home. Yes, I'm free. Try not to cry for me, just hold on to all our memories. Remember my smile and the things that we used to do, how you were always there for me, how much I love you. So celebrate the years, celebrate our family, and wipe each other's tears. Celebrate the laughter, celebrate the fun. One day God will wipe away your tears, and sorrow will be gone. I need you to celebrate my life.
Thank you, Gwen. That was such a blessing. I know it ministered to everybody in this room. Catherine Vanita Risen, a native Southern Belle of Pine Bluff, Arkansas, transitioned to be with our Heavenly Father on the morning of Monday, April 26, 2021. As the fifth of 10 children of Arnett Risen Sr. and Rosie Risen, she relocated to Flint, Michigan with her family as a young girl. While growing up in the city of Flint, Catherine became an educated alumnus of Central High School. Once entering the workforce, she was known to be a dependable and dedicated employee, later retiring from AC Spark Plug in the late 1970s. She later went on to become a teacher at Kurtz Head Start in Beecher, Michigan. She was a dedicated wife and mother of six beautiful children: Charles Jones of Boston, Massachusetts; Sean Jones of Atlanta, Georgia; Kadera and Sophia Jones of Baltimore, Maryland; Sonia Jones of Las Vegas, Nevada; Sherry and Christopher Daniels of Atlanta, Georgia;
and Chico Jones of Chicago, Illinois. Her upbringing provided her with the gift of knowing the Lord, which gave her a strong foundation for her faith and values throughout her life, which led her to one day become a member of Vernon Chapel in Flint, Michigan. Catherine was a true sports enthusiast. She was sure to be front and center of the nearest television to watch her football, basketball, tennis, and golf for her honorary grandson, Tiger Woods. Cooking was always her specialty, passing down many delicious dishes onto her children and grandchildren over the years, turning heads when she walked in, which she did, and she was always known to be the most stylish and sophisticated in the room. She will be remembered for her loving spirit and her caring ways. This special lady treasured her grandchildren and great-grandchildren with every part of her being. Catherine leaves to cherish her precious memories with her grandchildren, Tracy Jones, Alicia Jackson, LaRon Jones, Sharon Jones, James Jones Smith, Geronte Jones, Shania Jones, Aaliyah Jones Frazier, Cordero Jones Jr., Christopher Daniels, and 10 beautiful great-grandchildren. She will also be truly missed by her three sisters, Jamella Willis, Mertis and Van Coleman, and Patricia Morrison. Three brothers, Clevester and Ramona Risen, Webster Risen Sr., and Robert Risen. A host of nieces, nephews, cousins, other relatives, and many friends. Catherine was preceded in death by her parents, and three brothers, Mose Risen Sr., Ernest Risen, and Arnett Risen Jr. The family and community of Beecher will truly miss her beautiful smile and charismatic personality. Catherine will have a lasting impact on all of the lives she has encountered. The Jones and Risen family would like to extend their gratitude to all parties who have assisted in the prosperous homegoing of Catherine Vanita Jones. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. Give an honor to God and to the podium. I found a poem that I thought would really fit Miss Catherine Jones. She was definitely a special lady. This poem also is an acknowledgement from her friend and best friend and sister, Linda Allison, who cannot be here. I made it home. I just wanted to let you know that I made it home. Everything is so pretty here, so white, so fresh, so new. I wish that you could close your eyes so you could see it too. Please try not to be sad for me. Try to understand. God is taking care of me. I'm in the shelter of his hands. Here there is no sadness and no sorrow and no pain. Here there is no crying, and I'll never hurt again. Here it is so peaceful when all the angels sing. I really have to go for now. I've just got to try on my wings. P.S. I'll be the first face you see when you get here. Also, I have from Mayor Sheldon Neely and the city of Flint, a resolution of condolence on behalf of the residents of the city of Flint, Michigan. Be it resolved that I, Mayor Sheldon A. Neely, express my profound regret upon learning of the passing of Mrs. Catherine Vanita Jones. To all bereaved family, friends, and loved ones, I offer my most sincere and heartfelt sympathy. Sheldon Neely, Mayor, City of Flint. We also have a resolution from Bishop Gary Hawkins, founder and seer in memory of Mother Catherine Vanita Jones. Bishop Gary Hawkins, Sr., along with the Voices of Faith family, want you to know, Sister Shawn Jones and Sherry Daniels, that our thoughts and prayers are with your entire family during this difficult time. Your happy, creative, sincere, charismatic, and joyful mother is at peace. An angelic, super outgoing, courteous, stubborn, virtuous woman of God in great inner strength, great integrity, and great humanity is clothed with the sun and the moon under her feet, and upon her head is a crown of stars. She's enjoying God's heavenly adventures, joyfully and passionately strolling through the breathtaking celestial gardens. Yes, she's reached glory land, celebrating her 77th birthday year, Father God. From being and leaving a legacy of love with her down-to-earth, honest, considerate, loving, and cheerful personality that you could never forget, could always be heard saying, I love you, and stay in your lane. With her LA Lakers and Tiger Woods, her favorite golfer, of course, once again, her grandson, cooking and baking those delicious apple pies and peach cobblers, Miss Diva, Kitty Cat, her affectionate nicknames, is right now sharing her extraordinary joy of life by giving every angel, family member, and friend she encounters their own personal twinkling star, infused and outlined in pink, her favorite color, while God softly whispers, well done. Be comforted in knowing Mother Catherine Vanita Jones is at rest in the arms of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. To be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. There are a few other resolutions. I won't read everything because I know that it would be a longer service. Metropolitan Baptist Church, I have a resolution from Dr. Herbert Miller. Resolution for Miss Catherine Jones from Reverend Andre Powell Sr., Senior Pastor, Vermont Christian Church. I'm sure how to do this. And I also have another resolution from the Sanctuary at Kingdom Square, Anthony G. Macklin, Pastor. And I just want to say that I'm going to miss this lady. She was definitely a special person in my life. I'm so glad to have known the Jones family like I have. Thank you.
Amen. Certainly we thank all that have shared to this point. This time we're now opening the floor for those that want to share with this family briefly. We want you to come now and line up on this wall so that we know who you are and how many we have that's going to share with the family. You would just come now if you want to share with the family. If you're coming now, we would be still can't hear, can you? All right. Somebody might want to tell them that it's not working. If you would come now, if you're going to share with the family, come on this side and line up, if you will. Once we acknowledge the line, then we're going to allow those that's in line to come, and we'll ask you not to join the line while they're coming. I certainly want to give everyone that want to share with this family an opportunity. So if you want to come, if you'd come now, it would be helpful to us to know how many. We have two lovely young ladies in line at the current time. Amen. All right, we're going to, as soon as they give us the mic back, we're going to have them to come. Thank you so much. If you'd come now, these two young ladies will come and share with us. And after they come, we're going to have another solo by Sister Gwen Pennyman.
I just want to give honor to God and all the praise and glory. And y'all know the Jones family. I am y'all family. I'm going to miss Mama Jones. Sean, Charles, Chico, Cordero, Sonya, Sherry, all of y'all. I didn't write no speech, but I did want to speak and tell y'all how much I'm going to miss her and how much I love all y'all.
Yeah, it's me again. Anyway, I just want to say that everybody in this room knows what an amazing woman Mama Catherine was. And she taught me, she inspired me just by her fashion, her creativity, just her style. She was the most stylish person I know. And I can remember meeting her when I first met the family, or the family became my family. Miss Jones was the coolest and the sharpest mother in Beecher. And so she inspired me all the time. I'd go to her house, see what's new, let me try that and everything. But I just want to say that she was always a smile on her face. She always called me daughter. And she was always just a special person in all of our hearts. But I will continue to pray for the family. Y'all know that I'm there anytime. Anything you need, you always know to call me. God bless you.
I'd like to know, is the keyboard player still here? Because Miss Catherine was a live wire. She was not a sad, downtrodden person. So we're gonna lift this up in here a little bit. He's not here? All right, well, we don't need him. We got hands, we can clap. All right. Tragedies are commonplace. All kinds of diseases. People are slipping away.
Yes.
Economy's down. Can't get enough pay. As for me, all I can say is thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. Yeah. Folks without homes out in the street, and the scrub having some say they just can't be. Muggers and robbers, no place seem to be safe. But you've been my protection every step of the way. And I want to say thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. It could have been me outdoors with no food and no clothes, or just alone without a friend, or just another number with a tragic death. But you wouldn't see fit to let none of these things be. Every day by your power, you keep on. Keep on keeping me, and I want to say thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. Yeah, it could have been me outdoors with no food and no clothes, or just alone without a friend, or just another number with a tragic deed. But you wouldn't see fit to let none of these things be. Thank you, Lord, cause every day by your power, you keep on keeping me. And I wanna say thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. Hey, I wanna say thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. We needed a little bit of uplifting in here. And so there's the last one that I want to do is it reminds me of a mom and her children. And you know, we grow up and we go away and we come back. And this particular song is one that I've been singing quite a bit lately because it's so fitting either way, but really from a child to its parent. I'll miss you. I'll miss you for the rest of my life. Oh, I'm gonna miss you. Remember when you used to climb the stairs to hear me say my nightly prayers? I was afraid of the dark, so you'd stand close by until you'd see me close my eyes. I'm gonna miss you. My childish fears I'd hold within. Mama, I was afraid to tell you of the trouble I was in. And ooh, I'm gonna miss you. I grew up and went away, but Mama, I came back home just to say that ooh, I'm gonna miss you. For the rest of my life, Mama, I'm gonna miss you.
Amen. Certainly we thank her, Sister Pennyman, for those selections rendered. I would be remiss if we didn't allow Minister Tawana Perkins to come, followed by Elder Joanne Brown to come to just say something to this family.
I wasn't gonna say anything at first, but Mom would give me if I would. If anybody know that I love, I called her Mom. She was Mom, this Mama, but she was my Mom too. And anybody know if they knew Sherry Sanger, they knew who I was. I didn't doubt myself. In fact, I was just in the family. Amen. Amen. But I just thank God for her. She always encouraged me and Sherry. But me and Sherry would get in trouble because we always wanted to follow Sonya and them and do everything. Sonya, Sherry and Twine, y'all can't be going out doing that. And we'll sneak and do it anyway. And no, we'll get in trouble. But we wanted to do everything Sonya and all her friends did. And we didn't get a whoop at it. So what I did, I couldn't hang out. So I'm like, I'm spending the night with Sherry, because I know if I spend the night with Sherry, we can go everywhere. So we didn't care. So Mama said, I'm going up Sherry's house tonight, you know, because my mom and grandma weren't letting us go. My grandma was like, you be in the house at 11 o'clock with the dance, ain't over the 12. Oh, I'm spending the night with Sherry's house. One time I was like, well, we ran out of gas. She was like, yeah, we ran out of gas, grandmama, so we couldn't be late. So I mean, there was nothing she wouldn't do for us. And if anybody knew her, I don't know if y'all did it, but we had tacos at the house. If anybody know, then we know we're going to have tacos at the house. But I love you, Mom. I'm going to miss you, that pretty smile. Always, Tawana. I will never forget that voice. And my family, I love y'all. And Sherry, we all in Georgia, so I will see y'all. But for Sonya, Kadura, Charles Chico, I love y'all so much. Y'all, we all be encouraged, because I'm hurting just too, but I know we can make it all together. Amen. Yeah.
Well, I just want to say I'm going to miss Catherine as well. This is my oldest daughter, Tawana. And I do know Tawana and Sherry was so close and so tight. And Tawana used to always talk about Ma. She said, we're going to have some tacos over there. She was known for making those tacos. But I just like to say to the family, I love you all. And I want to tell you all to be encouraged. to be encouraged. Mom has gone on to be with the Lord, but she would want you guys to hold your head up high, be proud, be thankful for her being your mother. She was a good mother to you guys. So be thankful that she was the one God chose to be your mother. To be your mother. Yes. Yes. You could have had another mother, but God chose her to be your mother. So hold your head up and be proud for that sister, that pretty lady. That Catherine used to be the prettiest lady, as they say. She was the prettiest lady in Beecher. And I used to always admire her. And I'm like, oh, my God, my grandmama looked just like Catherine. But she was a beautiful lady. But you guys, Charles, Cadero, Sean, Sonia, Chico, and Sherry, you guys stick together and just know God is going to get you through this. Yeah, he's going to get you through this. And there is no sorrow that heaven cannot heal. So hold on to God's unchanging hand. He will keep you strong. And when you don't know what else to do, trust in the Lord with all thine heart. And lean not on your own understanding, but in all thy ways, trust and acknowledge him. And he said he will direct your path. So you got, you guys, you got a path, and you got to keep it going for Sister Kat. I love you guys. Be encouraged.
Let us pray. Now, Lord, we come again as humble as we know how. Lord, send the preacher now. Allow Overton to decrease. Allow the preacher now to increase. And Lord, I'll be grateful to give you all the praise, all the honor, all the glory. Hide me now behind your cross that they'll hear a word from you. Your servants pray in Christ's name, I pray. We say amen.
Amen.
I thought that it would be nice to let Minister Tawana Perkins and Elder Joanne Brown speak, but I'm not going to do that again. They both want to preach today, and they both of them got some fire shut up in their bones that they want to get out today. I need to tell them not today. Let me do my assignment today. To this family, no doubt you're hurting. I've been told there's no loss like the loss of a mother. I cannot tell you this early afternoon that I know your pain. My mother resides right there on Court Street. I cannot tell you that I know how you feel, but I can tell you about somebody who specializes in your hurt. I can share with you somebody who specializes in things that seems impossible. I know some of you are sitting here today saying, I don't know how I'm going to make it now without my mother. I can't pick up the phone and call now. What am I going to do? I want to tell you about a man named Jesus. Sticks closer than a mother. She shared with you earlier. It was Jesus who thought it would be befitting to let her be your mother. It was Jesus. He was the one who gave her the ability to shine and glow the way she did. I want to tell this family, no doubt your mother was proud of you all. When I look at you sitting there, I know she was proud of you. You all have went on and done well with your life. Things are even going to be brighter after today. I know you can't see it, but I want to share with you today that Mother will never leave you. You know, she was a unique woman and a special woman, and I just found out sitting here, this Mike and me not going to get along. Y'all need to fix this. You know, I don't like going to people's places and taking over, but I got a bad habit of doing it. But she was a unique lady because she comes from that state that's in the Bible. No other state is in the Bible, that state of Arkansas. Somebody said, Reverend, that's not in the Bible. Come, let me show you. Noah said, I looked out the ark and saw. It's there. It's there. It's there. She come from that state that even my mother is from Arkansas. Not just from Arkansas, but to make it even sweeter, she's from Pine Bluff, Arkansas. Yeah, Townsend Park to be exact. Yeah, my family is from Arkansas. Fact of the matter, my mother is home now packing up her bags. I don't understand it, but she's leaving me soon. She's on her way back to move to Arkansas. My sister moved there last year. Now she decided it's so nice and warm there. You know, I don't understand why people have been in Michigan for 50 and 70 years and talk about it's cold. It's the same cold that was here 50 years ago. It ain't got no different. It's the same cold. But listen, let me hurry on and get to this word. There's a word from the Lord today. It's tucked away in the book of 1 Corinthians, the 13th chapter. It says, if we speak human or angelic languages, but do not have love, I am a sounding gong or a clinging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so that I can move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. And if I donate all my goods and feed the poor, and if I give my body in order to boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love does not envy. It's not boastful. It's not conceited. Does not act improperly. It's not selfish. It's not provoked. And does not keep a record of wrong. Love finds no joy in unrighteousness, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believeth all things, hope all things, endures all things. I want to talk on a simple subject this morning, this afternoon, real quickly, on the subject of show some love. Show some love. Today, this family has chosen a color that I'm sure their mother picked, in the color of pink. Pink is a color that shows radiance and it shows class, and it signifies that you're good and confident with who you are. Yeah, come here, bro. When you can put on a pink shirt, a pink tie, it signifies that you a man. You ain't got no problem being a man. Step to me, I'll show you a man. I'm still a man. If you think I'm not a man, holler at me if you want to. It shows that I'm a man. For a woman, it shows I got class. I got elegance. Step out my way. Open up the door for me because I'm that kind of woman. I don't touch doors. I stand in front of the door so they might open the door for me. Mama had that kind of class. Yeah, mama had the kind of class that when she stepped in the presence of others, they were looking her up and down saying, ooh-wee, where'd she get that from? That show, I could have never put that together. But mama knew how to put it together in such a way of class that nobody else could understand. I feel like preaching. I'm starting to feel like it's Sunday morning. Tell the funeral director I might not make my time today, but I'm going to do what I got to do. Listen, my brothers and sisters, in this text today, we find Paul talking to the Corinthian church, and he tells them how important love is. Charlie, you the man now. Ain't no ands, ifs, buts about it. You got to step to the plate. You know, you was the man when mama was here, but now you're really the man.
Because you ain't got nobody to tell you to go sit down, shut up now. Because it didn't matter how big you got, how strong you got, how old you got, mama still boy gone and hush, I'm running this. But that time is gone now. You got to run this now. And how you run this is going to be through love. How you going to make everybody come to do what you need them to do is through love. And Paul tells the Corinthian church, the first thing he tells them is that talk is cheap. When he talks about if you got all these talking in languages and you have the ability to prophesy and do all this, that's just some conversation. That's cheap. Love cannot be a cheap love. Love cannot be superficial. And you know, that girl, I don't listen to that kind of music that much no more. I said that much. But she wrote a song. Y'all know, y'all heard the song. Don't act like y'all didn't hear. She talked about what love got to do with y'all. Who was that song that? Yeah, Tina Turner. She, you know, things happen to you when you get through some domestic violence. You have a tendency to stop thinking that love really means anything. But I wanted to tell Tina so bad, baby, love got everything to do with it. Love has everything to do with it. Family, I want to tell you today, don't just be talking about love. You know, we got this bad habit of call me if you need me. But then when I call you, you look at your call ID and don't answer for me. No. If I call you, I need you. And if I need you, I ought to be able to call you. And if I call you, you ought to answer the phone. Don't let your love be just a conversation and your talk is cheap. No. Don't let it be cheap. Now is the time that you got to show what mama really taught y'all. Yeah, before it didn't matter. But now it's time to show how she talked about united we stand, divided we fall. I wasn't in the house. I know. Somebody said, how he know mama said that? Because I just know mama was from Pine Bluff. And I know what she drunk down in Pine Bluff. And it just come natural from parents that come from Pine Bluff to tell their kids to always stick together. Always love one another. Now that she's gone, you got to love one another. Yeah, let this rise in the Jones family be a beacon light for the Beecher community. Yeah, be a beacon light that they might see the love that continues to shine. Although mother is gone, the love is still there. Yeah, not only does Paul tell them don't let the talk be cheap, but then he talks about over in verse 3, he says, and if I donate all my goods to feed the poor, can I tell somebody you can't buy love? You can't buy love. If you're wasting up your time trying to buy love, you're wasting your time. Love is not something you can purchase. Love is something that has to come from the heart. You can't even see the heart. You just got to believe that the heart speaks to the heart. You ought to be able to feel if somebody loves you. Y'all didn't hear what I said. Y'all missed it. I said you ought to be able to feel if somebody loves you. Can I tell you how every now and then I feel that my siblings love me? Every now and then my head get low and things get despondent in my life and things don't go the way I think they ought to go. And all of a sudden, one of my sisters will call me and say, what's going on? How you doing? Because their heart touched my heart, and because their heart touched my heart, when my heart is aching, something on their heart start bothering them, and they know to pick up the phone and say, something ain't right with my brother. Can I tell somebody, you can't buy that kind of love. I wish I had time. I really deal with that, because when you try to buy love, soon as your money run out, the love gonna run out. Fellas, I'm trying to help y'all if y'all would listen to me. I'm trying to help y'all, fellas. They don't love you. They love what you got, bro. I'm trying to help you, but you ain't trying to hear me. I got to get out of here. Y'all stop by Christ Fellowship. I talk like this on Sunday morning. Listen. Talk is cheap, and you can't buy love, but I'm glad. Paul closed with thing when he says, let me show you what love really looks like. Mother showed love. Yeah, Chico, you know she showed love. She long suffered. She was patient. She was kind. She waited for her children to mature and grow up. That's real love. You don't believe it's real love? Come and walk with me. I can show you mothers who walked away from their children. Didn't have no doubt, no thought about leaving them. But mother stayed and raised her children to be what they needed to be. I'm done. I got to let y'all go. But somebody said, Reverend Overton, that's all good. But that was their mother. But can I tell you about another demonstration of love? One Friday, my Lord and Savior, Jesus, the risen Christ, took your sin and my sin while I was yet in sin. Anybody know that he went to Calvary and died for me? Anybody know he died for you? But dying is not the end of the story, because early Sunday morning, he stepped out of the grave. I wish I had some time. I would tell you, when he stepped out of the grave, he had dynamite power called dunamis power. All power with heaven and earth were down in his hands. I'm done. When I tell you, we've got this thing all messed up now. Yeah, it's all. The world has kind of turned this thing flip side up. And I'm trying to get it right side up again. When I was a child, some of y'all can't remember, we used to play a game at night when you had to go home. We would play a game at night. We put our feet in a circle. Any meeny. Mike, you don't know you was in the house. Catch somebody by the toe. If he holler, let him go. Any meeny. Mo, you it today. Let's set the rules. See, the rules are always set at before the game starts. Now, you can go behind the tree. We're going to go behind the oak tree. You got to count to 100 by tens. And after you count to 100, we got two times to say we're not ready. And you got to go back and reset and do it all over again. Come, somebody. Y'all know what I'm talking about. We would go behind the tree and count 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. Here I come. Somebody over here would holler, I'm not ready yet. Got to go back behind the tree, because I know you had enough time to hide. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. Here I come. Some dude over here that was chasing a girl over there holler, I'm not ready yet. Now I'm indignant if I'm the one that's counting. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. But this time I would say, ready or not? Here I come. Come here. Come here. Don't leave me right there. Come here. Can I tell you, before there was ever anything put into this earth, before anything was in this world, God set the rules. And he said, listen, I'm going to let you have some time on earth. But when I call you, you can't say I'm not ready yet. The other day he called Miss Catherine and she says, I'm ready. Here I come. But can I tell somebody, when he calls your name, will you be ready? Because I got to tell you, when he calls you, you can't tell him you ain't ready. I'm leaving you when I tell you, if you're not ready, you have to get ready. You better get ready and get ready right now. Come in, Jason, help me out. Get ready, get ready, get ready, get ready, get ready. Because Jesus is on his way back. When he coming, no man know the day nor the hour. But he shall come. I got to quit. I got to quit. I'm starting to feel Sunday morning up in here. I got to quit. But listen, if you don't know Jesus, in the pardon of your sin, you better get to know him. It can be today. It can be right now. Things like this change people's lives. It can be in the day. Isaiah said it was in the day that King Uzziah died. I saw the Lord. Yeah, yeah. It can be it was in the day that Miss Catherine died. Yeah, yeah. That I accepted the Lord. All right. This day can be your day. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. If you don't know him, get to know him. Tomorrow just might be too late. Over in an old country church down there on Gilbert Street in the backwoods of Pine Bluff, Arkansas. My great-grandmother and my grandmother and them used to sing a song. This may be my last time. It may be my last time. I don't know. But if it's your last time, you better make sure you've asked Christ to be the Savior of your life. I'm trying to quit, but listen, I hear somebody speaking to me. Pastor Overton, I want to accept Christ, but I ain't got it together. I'm still drinking. I'm still letting sugar daddy take care of me. I'm still smoking a little herb. I'm still running to the club. But let me help somebody. Don't worry about that. You just get to know Jesus. He'll clean you up. He do the cleaning up. Don't you try to clean yourself up. Don't let me fool you now. Let y'all think that I'm doing everything perfect, because I'm not a perfect fella. I've had some shortfalls, but he's still working on me. I'm not what I used to be, but thank God he's still working on me. I know y'all got some of them fake superficial preachers that get up and tell you they all letting a bag of chips. No. Pastor Holy gonna tell you the truth. The Bible says it, and it's clear. All have sinned and fallen short of his glory. And if you need to come to Christ, you ought to come now and let him be your savior. I'm done. I gotta quit. I wish I had some more time. But listen, family, show some love. Love on one another. Make sure one another is taken care of. Don't take it for granted. Don't take it for granted. You might be doing well, but she might not be doing well. You might be doing all right, but he might not be doing all right. Make sure you check on one another. God bless you. And may heaven smile. Informed that we're going to do the committal here. For as much as please Almighty God, his wise providence, to take out of this world the soul of our deceased mother, we now therefore commit her body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust, looking for the general resurrection of the last days to come, when the dead in Christ shall rise first, and all of those of us that are left alive shall be caught up to meet him in the air. Until then, my brothers and sisters, comfort one another and remember that Jesus is on his way back. Let us pray. Oh, kind master, we come again to say thank you. Thank you for the life of our mother, grandmother, great-grandmother, a sister, a friend, a child of the King. Lord, we thank you for her presence here on earth, that we had a chance to know her, that we had a chance to meet her, that we had a chance to touch her. Now, Lord, we come, Lord, to just ask that you would touch this family and let them know that you God and you God all by yourself. You've never made a mistake. When you gave Catherine birth, you gave her an exit date. Now it's been her exit time, Lord. Comfort this family and let these children know that the same way you call their mother home, one day you will call them home too. And the question is that when you call us, Master, will we be ready? Lord, we can't say, I'm not ready yet. We recognize that when you call us, we have to come. And we thank you for it now, Lord. In Christ's name we pray, Lord, as we leave this place, go along with us. Allow them to get to the cemetery safely. Allow no hurt, harm, or danger. But most of all, Lord, bring this family tighter and closer together. And we thank you for it now. Bless these ministers that came and shared today. Strengthen their ministry, strengthen their lives. Thank you for their spirits today, Lord. In Christ's wonderful, precious, sweet name we pray. And all of God's people said amen.
Amen. Thank you so much, Pastor.
Bless you.
We have a lot of flowers today. Could we ask about 30, 40 legacy flower bearers, please? About 30. Thank you.
Pray for me.